Greetings. Today in this video session, we are going to discuss about the transmission medium. Right? We know very well that the transmission medium is very, very important to transfer a data from sender to receiver. So here the physical layer will have this transmission medium. So here in this transmission medium, either we can go for a cable or we can use a air, or the signal or frequencies can be used to transfer the information from sender to the receiver. So either it may be a connection oriented or a connectionless service. So if it is a connection oriented, we wanted to use a cable. If it is a connectionless, then we can use a frequency or the air can be used to transmit our data from sender to receiver. So this is very, very important thing, or it is playing a vital role for establishing a communication between the layer in the sender side as well as the layer, physical layer in the receiver side. So here, as far as this transmission medium is concerned, it is broadly defined that it carry information from source to destination. Here it need a transmission medium. More specific transmission medium is needed to transfer the information from source to destination. So here the transmission medium may be of free space, I told air, or you can use a metallic cable. That is a cable, you can use a connection oriented cable, or you can go for a fiber optic cable. The information usually a signal that it is the result of conversion of data from another form. So I already told the signal will be in the form of analog, and after that it will be converted as a digital and it will be transferred to the destination. That is the meaning of conversion to the another form. And here under this transmission media, generally it is classified into two category. One is called guided medium. All wired communications are coming under guided medium, and another medium is called as unguided medium. So all the wireless communication is coming under the unguided medium. So as far as in this video session, we are going to discuss only the guided medium, that is twisted pair cable, coaxial cable and fiber optic cable. So these three things we are going to discuss today. So here in this guided media, that will provide a conduit from one device to another. It is nothing but establishing a connection or a channel or a tube which will establish a communication between the source and destination, or the sender and the receiver. So this conduit will be, either it may be a twisted pair cable or coaxial cable or fiber optic cable. So a signal traveling along any of this media is directed and contained by the physical limit of the medium. So here it is having its own restriction, that is twisted pair is having its own restriction compared to fiber optic cable. So based on the requirement or based on the cost, we can implement this medium. And especially this twisted pair as well as coaxial cable use a metallic copper conductors that accept and transport signal in the form of electric current. So it will be transferring the information in the form of electric current. So the third category is optical fiber. It is a cable that accept and transport signal in the form of light. So here it will be in the form of electric current, and here it will be in the form of light. So we know very well that optical fiber is very faster compared to this twisted pair or coaxial cable, but the cost of implementation of optical fiber is very, very high. And here we'll see how the twisted pair cable is functioning. A twisted pair cable consists of two conductors. By name itself, we can understand twisted pair. Pair represent two. So it is having a two conductors, that is normally copper, and that is with the own plastic insulation, that is covered with the copper wire covered in insulation. So one of the wire is used to carry a signal, and another wire will be referenced for ground reference. Right, two wires are there. One will be acting as a signals to the receiver, and another wire will be representing the ground reference. So it will be identified by the receiver. So when the receiver receives the signal, it identify which one is bringing the signals and which one is used for reference. It will be identified by the receiver. So here it will be twisted. Why it is not twisted, or we can say why it is twisted, why it is not parallel. So what will happen if it is parallel? So if it is a parallel, one wire will be closer and one wire will be having a distance. It will create a noise. To one wire it will create a noise, and another wire will transmit the data in a normal manner. To overcome this problem, only these wires are twisted together. So this results the difference at the receiver. By twisting the pair, the balance is maintained. So to maintain the balance between the wires, it will be twisted so that the noise will be in a normal level. So one wire won't get disturbance, other wire also won't get disturbance. If the disturbance is there, it will be for both. So that is the reason why we are twisting the wires. And here the twisted pair wires will be coming under two category. One is called unshielded and another one is shielded twisted pair. So here, as far as unshielded twisted pair is concerned, this is the way in which the unshielded twisted pair will be there. The wire will be there and it is covered with plastic cover. So the problem with this unshielded twisted pair is, so there is a possibility of more interference. That is the reason why we are going for shielded twisted pair. So in this shielded twisted pair, a metallic shield will be there covered with the wire, and outer jacket will be the plastic cover, so that the disturbance or noise will be less in the case of that is a shielded twisted pair. So here either we can go for a pair that is a unshielded one, or we can go for a shielded twisted pair cable. And second category is coaxial cable. So it is represented as coax. It carries signal for higher frequency range than that of twisted pair. So here the advantage is it can take higher signals than compared to twisted pair cable because of two media are constructed quite differently. So here, instead of having two wires, this coaxial having a central core conductor, that is a solid strand wire. Only one wire is there in the case of coaxial cable, enclosed in insulating sheet, which in turn encased in outer conductor of metal foil or braid or combination of two. So two covering will be there in the case of this coaxial cable. So the outer metallic wrapping serves both as a shield against noise and the second conductor which complete the circuit. The outer conductor is also enclosed in an insulating sheet, and the whole cable is protected by a plastic cover. See here, in this you are having a plastic cover. Inside that you will be having a insulator, and inside that insulator you are having an outer conductor which is shielding the cable, and here again you will be having an insulator, so that there are two insulators, so that it is protecting the noise from outside, the interference from outside. It is also protected from damage. That is the advantage of having a coaxial cable. So that is the reason why the transmission capacity having a higher frequency in coaxial cable compared to twisted pair cable. So this is the arrangement for coaxial cable. Now we will see how this fiber optic cable will be there. So the fiber optic cable is made of glass or plastic and transmit signal in the form of light. So we know very well that the twisted pair or coaxial cable will be using an electric signal, but in the case of fiber optic, it uses a light. The signal will be in the form of light. So we know very well that light will transmit in a very fast manner compared to signals, the ordinary signal. The light signal will traverse in a faster manner by means of refraction. Optical fibers use reflection to guide the light through a channel. So here, what will happen, it is having a cladding. So it is a protecting environment, or it is nothing but the cladding is nothing but a glass or plastic. So here this cladding will allow, or it will protect the light to go out of this wire, fiber optic cable. So because of that, the reflection will be taking inside that line itself, or inside the wire itself, optical fiber cable itself. Because of that, there is no leakage of light and there is no interference. Without interference, it can travel for long distance. For example, if you use a coaxial cable or twisted pair cable for 5 km and here in the fiber optic we can go for 50 km. For example, in the coaxial cable or twisted pair, every 5 km you wanted to give a regenerator. The signal has to be regenerated. But in the case of fiber optic cable, even you can send a data for 50 km. After that, you can have a regeneration mechanism. That is the advantage of having fiber optic cable. And under this fiber optic cable, there are two different modes. One is called multi-mode and another one is called as a single mode. So here the propagation mode represents that the light, the traveling mechanism of the light is represented as a propagation mode. So under this multi-mode, there are two categories again. One is called step index and another one is called as a graded index. We will see what is the difference between step index and graded index. So since the name itself, from the name itself, we can understand that multi-mode of light will generate multiple beams, right? The beams are multiple number of beams can be generated in the case of multi-mode from the light source. And it will be moving through the core. So here I told in the multi-mode again it is divided into two categories. One is called step index and another one is called as a graded index. And how we can identify the beams which are or the light source will be moving inside the structure will be depends on the cable which we are using. So here if it is a step index, what will happen? This is the light source and you will be having a reflection. You can see that high reflection and low reflection, like that high and low straight line reflection will be there. That is called a step index. And the curved model, right, the reflection is called as a graded index. Okay, so these are the two different mechanism under multi-mode. And another one is called as a single mode. The single mode is nothing but the light will be traveling in a straight line, exactly 90 degree to reach at the destination. This is the single mode is very, very best compared to this multi-mode or step index or graded index. The single mode is best, but the cost of implementation of the single mode is very high. So that is the reason why I told multi-mode will have the density code remain constant and a beam of light move through the constant density straight line until it reaches the interface of the core or cladding. So cladding will protect to avoid a refraction. So here the interface, there is an abrupt change due to lower density. So it will come to lower density and after that it will take a reflection and it will go for higher density. Lower density, higher density, like that. So the term step index refers that suddenness of this change. That is the reason why it is called step index. It will go high and come to low and then go high and come to low. So that is the reason why it is called as a step index. And the next one is graded index fiber. It decreases the distortion of the signal through the cable. The word index here refers to the index of refraction. So here it is purely related to density. So it is varying a different density and it will travel through the path. And density is the highest at the center of the core and decreases gradually to the lowest edge. So here you can see that here it will be in a highest. In the core part, it will be highest. The coverage will be highest. The clarity will be more in the center part. And when it is go slow also, the clarity will be less. And when go high also, the clarity will be less. So that is the advantage of, or that is the basic difference between step index and graded index. And last one I told is single mode. In single mode fiber, the manufactured for smaller diameter. So the thickness or diameter of the fiber is very, very small. So whenever the fiber optic cable size is very, very thin, then automatically the cost will be high. And here it is having a lower refraction and high reflection and light will pass through exactly 90 degree. So the clarity, you will be getting very high clarity. So all the beams arrive at the destination together. So when the beams are arriving together at the same time and same speed, then it doesn't have any disturbance, so that it will be having a less distortion to the signal. The interference will be very very less compared to multimode. Single mode is having a very less disturbance in the case of fiber optic cable. And here this is the construction of fiber. You will be having an outer jacket, and inside that you will be having a what? Kevlar for strength, and you will be having a plastic buffer inside that, and before that you will be having a cladding, and inside that only the core part will be available, that cable. We know very well that the fiber optic cables are very very thin, like even it is less than our hair thickness. The diameter of the fiber optic cable is very very less, so that is, it is less than the diameter of our hair. So that much of thin cable will be used inside this cladding. So by using that only we are going to transmit the data in a faster manner from source to destination. So here this optical fiber will have a outer jacket. It will be made of PVC or Teflon, and inside that you will be having a Kevlar strand to strengthen the cable to avoid a leakage of, because it is light is traveling, so that it has to be protected, so that to increase the strength the Kevlar jacket will be there. And it is a strong material is used for fabrication of bulletproof vest, right? So here that much of strong material is used for creating a Kevlar strand. So it is a bulletproof vest which is fabricated, so that metal will be used for Kevlar strand. And below the Kevlar strand another plastic coating is there for protecting the fiber. And in the center of the cable is at the center of the core part is available at the center of the cable, and it should be protected by using a cladding. So this is the way in which the fiber optic cable will be arranged. And here when you talk about the advantage and disadvantage of optical fiber is, so it is having a higher bandwidth. I already told, compared to twisted pair or coaxial cable, it is having a higher bandwidth. And it is having a less signal attenuation. So why? Because the coaxial cable or twisted pair is using a electric signal, but here in this case of light source. So because of that, it is traveling without any disturbance in long period of time, so that the repeaters we can avoid in the case of optical fiber. And here immunity to electromagnetic interference. So magnetic interference will not be possible in the case of fiber optic, but in the case of other coaxial or the twisted pair cable will be having more electromagnetic disturbances. And it is resistance to other corrosive material. So corrosive material. So it is protected from the resistant. It is having a resistance to protect from the corrosive material. And here the weight of the cable is very very less, lightweight, and greater immunity to tapping. That is very very important. Tapping is nothing but extracting information from the fiber optic cable is not at all possible, but in the case of other twisted pair or coaxial cable it is possible. The main disadvantage of having this fiber optic cable is installation and maintenance. It is finding the error finding is very difficult in the case of optical fiber. And here another biggest disadvantage of this fiber optical is it is having a unidirectional light propagation. Only one direction alone it can able to transfer the data. If suppose you wanted to send and receive data, two fibers need to be installed. But installing two fiber is not a problem, but the cost of implementation will go very high. That is a drawback of using optical fiber. It is very fast, the bandwidth is very good. Without any disturbance we can perform a data transmission, but the important drawback is the installation is very difficult, maintenance is also having a problem, and it is having a unidirectional. If you want to perform a bidirectional data transmission or communication, you need to install two fiber optic cables, and cost of implementation, because of that the cost of implementation will also be high. So in this video session what we have discussed under the transmission medium, it is divided into two parts. One is guided medium and another one is called unguided medium. Under the guided medium, we have discussed what is right coaxial cable and what is twisted pair cable and what is the optical cable. So thank you.